So the 1980s were considered the golden age of hip-hop, with groups like Run-DMC, LL Cool J, The Fat Boys, Eric B. and Rakim, Public Enemy, EPMD, and the Beastie Boys, putting hip-hop on the musical map. Rap music put a permanent stamp on the musical landscape and announced to the world that it was here to stay and not just an overnight fad. The Beastie Boys, also out of New York City, paved the way and proved that white guys could actually rap. But I want to talk about a very influential hip-hop group that's been largely overlooked and forgotten in the annals of hip-hop history. Two white guys hailing from Queens, New York, Third Bass.
A branch of the hip-hop tip grills your dome. Your tone gone low, showing you ain't got nobody home. Roll to the microphone, light up and take out. Make out your will, Bill 3 is gonna break out the styly. Me and P.E.T.E. embark on a mission that's deadly. Break out the ammo. Hey yo, Sammo, hook up the beat and I lay the plan. Oh man, you just got taken.
So MC Search from Far Rockaway, Queens, already had a record deal in place when he was persuaded to meet up with another white rapper named Pete Nice. Pete Nice, who already had studio time bought and paid for, was stood up, met up with Search, and Search was so impressed with him, they decided to write and record, and immediately Third Bass was born. Originally, they were going to be called Three the Hard Way, but due to a movie conflict, they couldn't use the name, so Pete Nice, being an avid baseball fan, decided to change the name to Third Bass. So MC Search, Pete Nice, and their DJ Richie Rich recorded their very first album in 1988 called The Cactus Album. So the Cactus Album was released in November of 1989. It was produced by Sam Sever, Prince Paul, and the Bomb Squad, who had worked with Public Enemy. One of the interesting things about the Cactus Album is that depending on the format, it would be the Cactus Album, or the Cactus CD, or the Cactus Cassette. To this day, I've never seen anyone else do that. So the Cactus Album peaked at number 5 on Billboard's top hip-hop charts and number 55 on the Billboard 200, and was also certified gold, powered by the first single, Step Into the AM.
Oh, you don't stop moving until the Search says so, to keep the tribe open. Shooting out the play 'em, Three the Hard Way, and keep it Step Into the AM.
Now, this album was loaded with hits from Step Into the AM to Brooklyn Queens to Product the Environment to my favorite, Words of Wisdom, and also The Gas Face. And that song created some controversy. So according to MC Search, Hammer put out a $50,000 hit on him, to which Hammer vehemently denies. However, there's been several different versions of the story floating around, including a confrontation, to which Search and Pete Nice have very different stories. So it's completely up to who you believe.
Monday.
Hammer, don't hurt him.
And you're...
So in 1991, Third Bass releases their sophomore album, which is called Derelicts of Dialect, which includes the hit song Pop Goes the Weasel, which takes shots at Vanilla Ice and basically anyone selling out in general. The funny thing is that this song became such a huge hit, kind of nullified its message.
Got a squad with a list of complainers. I should have started rape. Rappers against phony entertainers, so we can make it known that we won't get swayed. It's 91, son, so something's gotta change.
Getting paid, pedal sneakers and soda pop.
Pop, pop,
pop, pop goes the weasel, his drawers drop, drop, drop. Why not take your top 10 pop head? Fix the music and make sense, this rhymes fit.
The song peaked at number 29 on the Billboard Hot 100 and the album went gold. Sadly, it was a swan song for the band because due to creative and personal differences, they would break up shortly thereafter. Both artists embarked on solo careers. MC Search released his first album in 1992, entitled Return of the Product, and also featured the hit, Here It Comes, The song did reach number one on the rap singles charts.
Here it comes, yo, here it is, oh, there it was. But where was it when you needed it? Because you fall to the waistline when your waist rhymes. Search got a flow when it comes to fat beats and bass lines. I heard the rumors and the fables, remove them like the tumors on tables. Rumors for the willing and the able.
Pete Nice would release his own solo album in 1993 entitled Dust to Dust, featuring the song Kick the Bobo.
The Prime Minister kicked the Willie Bobo.
While an official reunion never took place, there were rumors of a third album entitled Ichabod's Cranium that never came to fruition. However, Search did release some of the tracks from that album, including one of my personal favorites, Cats in the Cradle.
Cats in the cradle with his microphone. Shorty mom doomsday, both home all alone. Dad, when you coming home, son, I don't know when. But we'll have a good time then. Kick a few rhymes then, spit a few lines then. You know we'll have a good time then.
After the breakup of the group, MC Search remained active in the music industry. He produced Nas's Illmatic, formed a company, Searchlight Productions, and also started VH1's reality series, The White Rapper Show. He also hosted a AM morning show called Search in the Morning in Detroit. Pete Nice left the music industry behind entirely in 1995 to focus more on baseball history and memorabilia. He opened up his own baseball memorabilia shop in Cooperstown, New York. And Pete Nice also wrote a book about legends of Brooklyn's Greenwood Cemetery under his own name, Peter Nash. Third Base did have a reunion of sorts back in 2013. They reformed and played a few gigs, one of which being this one. Yeah, it took me a minute to realize that was Pete Nice. You know, age is eventually catches up to all of us. So you would think, after all these years, these two had finally settled their differences. All's well that ends well, right? Well, about that.
You know what?
I wrote so many of your fucking rhymes, B.
Oh my God!
Phone right now before
you're such a clown. You know what you said on Sway? You know what you said on Sway, Search? You said that we lit a fire under Rakim. We lit a fire.
I'm telling you right now.
Did Rakim know about it if we lit a fire under him and had him finish the record in 2 weeks? So you took credit for following the leader. You know what, Search? You're a pathological liar. You're the Trump of hip-hop. That's what Paradise called you yesterday when I was talking to him about that.
Meanwhile, you're
the Trump of fucking hip-hop.
You're the fucking one who voted for Trump. You're
really? 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 Like you even know me at this point, sir.
Millions of dollars.
What a fucking clown. What a fucking clown.
Living in a fucking foreclosed home.
What a fucking clown.
Doesn't even take care of his own fucking children.
Search talking reckless. Search fucking reckless as usual.
Shut the fuck up.
Pathological liar who's admitted it time and time again.
Yo, I wrote your fucking rhymes on products of the environment.
Yeah.
The lyrics that you fucking put out there. Yo, B.
Really?
You're fucking full of shit and you're a fucking
clown, Search.
And this is all really cute. That you get on the radio.
So, unfortunately, it appears that these two probably will never be on speaking terms again. And that's a real shame because together with Richie Rich, they created two classic albums, especially the Cactus album, and ushered in a new era for white rappers especially and paved the way for rappers that were to follow. The Beastie Boys were the first mainstream white rappers, but Third Base were the first traditional rap group because the Beastie Boys, to me, they were always more of a fusion group because they would mix rap and rock together with other sounds. But Third Base, they were straight old school hip hop the moment they came out. And I don't think they get the credit that they deserve. So in the annals of hip hop history, I think Third Base definitely have a place on the mantle aside the other greats of that era, and they were truly ahead of their time. I think these guys were trailblazers, and they proved that white guys could rap. So, sadly, we may never get another Third Base album, But at least we have those two classic albums to go back and listen to. So if you want to know more about old school hip hop, especially back in the 80s, I would definitely recommend you start with Third Bass. Thank you for watching.